for backward reaction, what will be here? For backward reaction, for backward reaction, now we can write that one. What it is here? 2NH3 gives rise N2 plus 3H2. So now we can write Kp is equal to Kc RT to the power of delta N. Delta N is nothing but 4 minus 2. So N is equal to here the 2. So now you can write what will be here. Kp is equal to Kc RT to the power of 2. Okay. So it is the relationship between the Kp and Kc for different type of the examples. Based upon this one, one 4 marks question will be came. Okay, so here the delta N is nothing but number of moles of products minus number of moles of reactants. It is the information about the Kp and Kc. Next one here. So here it is the relationship. Next one, in our chemical equilibrium applications. What is the next topic here? Applications. Applications of chemical equilibrium. Okay, applications of chemical equilibrium or chemical equilibrium constant. Okay, so applications of chemical equilibrium tells here the main important two terminologies. Number one here, the predict the extent of chemical reaction. Okay, number one, what it is here, the predict the extent of chemical reaction. Number two here, predict the direction of chemical reaction. Predict the direction of chemical reaction. First of all, number one, predict the extent of chemical reaction. So listen, so based upon here the Kc values, based upon which one here the Kc values, if the Kc value is greater than 10 to the power of 3, greater than 10 to the power of 3, that should indicates here products predominates over the reactants. Okay, whenever the Kc value is greater than 10 to the power of 3. If the Kc is less than 10 to the power of minus 3, it indicates here quite opposite. What will be here? Reactants predominates over the products. Okay, if Kc is equal to 10 to the power of minus 3 to 10 to the power of 3, it indicates here the equilibrium. It indicates which one here? The equilibrium. It indicates which one here? Equilibrium. So for this process, for example, whenever I am using this arrow mark, okay, in this arrow mark, it is the 10 to the power of minus 3 and it is the 10 to the power of 3. Okay, so here it should be present like chemical equilibrium, and this indicates here the hardly reactants is going on. It tells about here the almost large extension of reaction explains. It is the information, applications of chemical equilibrium. Number one, predict the extent of chemical reaction. Based upon the equilibrium constant, Kc is equal to 10 to the power of 3 tells about the products predominates over the reactants. If the Kc is less than 10 to the power of minus 3, tells about here the reactants predominates the over products. If the Kc is equal to 10 to the power of minus 3 to 10 to the power of 3, that should be tells about the equilibrium. Next, one more word, what it is here, the predict the direction of chemical reaction. Okay, that means either forward reaction takes place or backward reaction takes place or the chemical equilibrium. For this process, we can use one of the constant, reaction quotient. We are using here, what it is here, the reaction quotient. It is indicated with which one here, the QC. QC is nothing but Kc. QC also nothing but Kc. KC will depends upon the concentration of the reactants, but QC not the concentration, that is the different. KC tells about here the extent of reaction, QC tells about here the direction of the reaction. Okay, QC tells about which one here the direction of the reaction. For example, as it is, if you want to write the A, B, C, D, D, for this one you can write QC is equal to same C concentration, D concentration, A concentration, B concentration. It is the QC. Okay, so based upon the QC and KC, here we can say which reaction takes place. For example, it is our QC value, it is our KC. It is the KC value, it is the QC value. That means QC is less than KC. That indicates which one here? The forward direction. It tells about which direction here? The forward direction. If the QC equal to the KC, if QC equals to the KC, it tells about the equilibrium. It tells about which one here? The equilibrium. If the QC is greater than KC, it is the QC, it is the greater. It tells about backward reaction. It tells about which one here? The backward reaction. Okay, prediction of the direction of chemical reaction depending upon the reaction quotient. What is the reaction quotient here? The it is nothing but the ratio between the molar concentration of products by molar concentration of reactants. It is also equal to the KC, but KC tells about the extent of reaction, QC tells about the direction of reaction. Okay, so QC always depends upon here the KC. Okay, if the QC is less than KC, QC is less than KC, that tells about which one here the forward reaction. If the QC is equal to KC, that tells about here the equilibrium. Next of all, QC is greater than KC, that tells about here the backward reaction. Okay, these are the main important applications of chemical equilibrium. And also it tells about the always chemical equilibrium depends upon the temperature. Always depends upon here the temperature. And whenever we are taking the molar concentration, molar concentrations also molar concentrations are useful for the equilibrium constant, but molar concentration for the reaction quotient is negligible. It is the main difference. These are the main applications of chemical equilibrium.